Sure, being warm is nice, but did you know cold is good for you? That it can help you lose fat and build muscle? It can help you think better and faster. It can help heal almost any illness, and it helps you live longer. Cold therapy can boost metabolism up to 500%. It burns calories and fat, clears blood glucose levels, helps build muscle, enhances exercise recovery, rebalances hormones, and helps cells live longer. The longest living people live in places where it gets cold, whereas people living in the tropics usually don't live as long. Parasites, bacteria, and viruses love warmth. That's why so many people get terribly sick when on vacation in warm tropics. And that's why hospitals and doctor's offices are so cold. The main reason people get sick in the winter, it's not because of the cold, it's because they eat processed, unnatural, warm comfort food and don't move their bodies very much. Car engines have more horsepower when it's cold, and electricity moves faster and better in cold. Supercomputers must be in refrigerated rooms. The colder it is, the faster information moves because there's less resistance in matter. Your body's electrical and nervous system works better, faster, and much more efficiently. My office where I work is cold. The air conditioning is always on, even in the winter. I'm like a supercomputer when I work. The cold helps me focus and be more alert. The most advanced, powerful cultures and richest cities in the world with the most technological advancements are all in the colder northern latitudes, New York, Tokyo, Berlin, Moscow, London, none in the tropics. Sleep is much better when it's cold. It's very healing. Ever heard of hot cold therapy? It's in my book, Heal Yourself 101, if you ever read it. When you're hot, your skin gets red because the heated blood goes outwards to your skin's surface to cool off. When you get cold, the blood rushes inwards to protect your vital organs and keep them warm, so your skin gets white. Hot cold therapy is when you stand in the shower and douse yourself with really cold water for 30 seconds. Then turn the water hot and stand in the hot water for 30 seconds. Then ice cold again for 30 seconds. Then hot water again for 30 seconds. Do this half a dozen times. Each time the pain will be less and less until finally you're so numb you don't even feel the cold anymore. In fact, you'll feel amazing. In the winter, we move our bodies less and our blood and lymph become stagnant. What you are doing with hot cold therapy is forcing all the blood in your body to rush inwards, then outwards, then inwards, then outwards, then inwards. You're washing your entire insides. It's very healing. It helps get everything moving. In fact, people have held shower heads on skin cancer spots, and after many hot cold sessions, the spot just fell off. This helps any pain or illness you may have in your body. It's great for lazy people, wheelchair people, paralyzed people, and sick people. In areas where it's snowy, it's common for people to jump back and forth between a hot tub and snow. Last year, I posted some pictures of naked German people sitting outside covering themselves with snow. A few uptight people were upset about the image subject matter and asked to be unsubscribed from the newsletter. Jeez, some people just don't get it. They need to do this. Cold burns stubborn fat. The most stubborn fat is brown cells, which you can kill with cold. Dr. Schultz and Christopher are famous for putting people in bathtubs filled with ice cubes to help heal incurable diseases. People in America scream for their lives when this is done to them. They literally have to be held down by several other people. That's funny because professional athletes take ice baths all the time to heal injuries, recover faster, and help their muscles grow faster. In other countries, especially Northern Europe, ice baths are actually quite common in the natural healing world, and for people trying to lose stubborn fat. The colder it is, the more fat you lose. And despite what some people say, yes, you can spot reduce fat in specific body areas by strapping cold packs to your abs or butt. It's called cold thermogenesis, which causes blood glucose to be burned off as fuel before it can turn into fat. Adiponectin is a hormone released by cold that breaks down fat and sends glucose into muscles, increasing the number of skeletal muscle mitochondria, meaning it helps your muscles grow and heal faster. Athletes have known this forever. Many raw foodists complain they're always cold. Good, that means they're healthier. Most people are in the permanent state of inflammation where their bodies are chronically trying to burn off some kind of low-level infection. They're so used to it, they think being warm or hot is normal. Actually, cold is more normal. Lab studies have shown that animals with a lower body core temperature can live much longer, up to 2 times longer. And part of what raises body temperature is digestion. It's just hard work on the body. Eating less lengthens your life. And as for feeling cold, here's what I do. Take your clothes off and let yourself get as cold as you possibly can for as long as you can. Walk around the house naked or even better, outside in the winter, whatever. Then take a hot bath or shower and go, ah. Then later, let yourself get cold again. And then go through that warm, hot bath or shower. Go through this several times a day and watch how you feel. As the years go by, you'll find yourself acclimating more and more to the cold to the point where you can go out in the snow wearing only shorts. I know, a lot of you are thinking, ice baths? Cold therapy? No, thank you. I'm going to try another alternative therapy. But remember, always staying in the comfort zone is what got you sick, bored, and unhappy in the first place. Not just with your body, but with your personal relationships and money health also. If you want to really thrive and be successful, you must constantly be breaking your comfort zones. If you learn to not be afraid by using cold therapy, it might just help you with not being afraid to do other things in your life that are keeping you in a rut. It's all connected. At least approach it this way. Okay, so being in ice cold water in the winter is not fun, but it makes getting into the hot tub 30 seconds later something to really look forward to. Then, once you're in the hot tub, you feel a sense of accomplishment and newfound courage, seeing that you survived it. So you go again for another 30 seconds in the cold swimming pool or shower. Again, you look forward to the hot water. After the fourth round, you'll notice how the cold doesn't even affect you anymore. You're starting to become superhuman. You feel refreshed, clean, calm, focused, and alive like never before. And that's my job, to wake you up and show you what real living is really like.